continue with developing our walk cycle, I've brought in my little character here, and I've added all of the parenting. So at this point, I'm ready to start building the actual walk cycle. What I like to do is use something of a template that will give me examples. So I have imported this image, and you can see it here in the background, and it's actually backwards. So my character is obviously walking in this direction, and the sample is walking in that direction. It's very easy in my main composition. I went and I just flipped it over. The next thing I want to do is set a baseline. So you can see there's a baseline in the sketch, which is really important as our character's walking. The foot needs to hit that ground or baseline to make it look somewhat realistic as the character's walking forward. Remember, we're doing more of a marching in place, and then we'll move that marching composition through our timeline. So let's get going. We've got an awful lot of layers here. And I want to be able to see my template. So what I've done is I've set it somewhat transparent, because when I don't, well, you'll see what happens. Can't see my figure. So I've just made it somewhat dark. Make whatever adjustments you need to do for your character. And then I want to be able to view the rulers. Command R, or you can go up to the view. And I'm going to pull a line here that I'm going to use as my baseline. And last but not least, we have so many darn layers here. What I wanted to do was hide. I'm going to start by working just with the legs. And so I want to hide all of these extra layers so they have a little bit of room to move. And then, so you'll notice this little guy. He looks like Kilroy to me. So he's the one who can hide your layers. So I'm going to click on everything pretty much from the rib cage up, which includes his arms and hands and even his head. And I'm going to make those shy layers. Now I'm going to click on him, and it's going to hide my shy layers and give me a little bit more space to work with, but not a whole lot, because we have to open up all of these layers. So I'm going to focus primarily also on rotation, with the exception of, in my case, the hips, because I have everything parented to the hips. So I'm going to select all, and I'm going to hit R, which is going to open up my rotation. And I'm right at the beginning of my timeline, so I'm going to just click once on the stopwatch, and that's going to set a keyframe, an initial keyframe, for all of my rotation positions. And then I'm just going to choose the hip, and I'm going to actually hold down the shift key and hit P, which is going to give me also position. So I'm going to make a position keyframe for my hips. And I'm ready to roll. So I like to work from the hips down, and when I'm working on the arms, from the upper arm down. You'll find it much easier than starting with the foot. So let's see if I can get away with making this a little bit bigger. We can zoom in on the legs. And obviously, looking at my skeleton figure compared to the little drawing template, I have got a much taller, skinnier character. I'm just going to use my template as sort of a guide for the leg positions. And what I want to do is take a look at the character. Yeah, I'm going to try and take a look at the character and align the hip position. That's the most important thing. And to do that, what I want to do is align my drawing. So I want to get to that layer. I want to unlock my template, and I want to move it over a little bit so that I'm somewhat in line with the hips. So if I were up here, that's great. And then I can just hold the shift key and move straight downward. Put the foot on the baseline, ready to go. I recommend that you lock that layer. And then let's take the thigh, starting with the thigh, and I can go upward, find that thigh, and I'm just going to use the sliding rotation instead of trying to type in the numbers. So I've got something of a straight leg there. Don't worry about the position just yet. Get the legs into the right angles first. And the foot. And then I'm going to go to my other leg, do the same thing. Now notice in the little drawing that I have, it highlights that the back leg in this case is black and the front leg is white. So I need to be mindful of which leg I'm moving. You can get some very strange results if you move the wrong leg at the wrong time. So let's get the calf. And I'm not going to have you watch me do this whole thing because it's not very exciting, but I do want to take this a little bit further, and then I'll pause and continue after I've got all of my sketches done. Okay, so now I've got the legs more or less in the similar position as the template. So now at this point, I'm going to grab those hips and I'm going to move it down. And you'll see that when I move the hips, everything moves because it is parented to those hips. All right, so now I have got an 8-second long composition at this point in time. I want to go to the very end of my composition because the first and last positions need to be the same for it to loop perfectly. And at this point, I want to do a select all, and I'm going to hit keyframe, and that should do keyframes for my entire visible unlocked skeleton. So now that I have everything in position, I'm moving my playback head to the second number one after zero. I'm going to do the second position. I realize that's going to give me a very slow walk cycle, but that doesn't really matter because I'll be able to speed it up at the end. So what I want to do at this point is deselect, get to the bottom where I have my little template, unlock it, slide it so that I can see the second drawing, keep that baseline in position, and try and align again, more or less, where the hips fall. I've got that. I want to lock it. Then I want to select all again, and once again, make a new keyframe. Guess what? I get to do the whole thing all over again. So let's go back up to my first upper leg here, and I'm going to change the rotation, obviously, so that it's a little bit higher. And then go down to the calf, rotate it back so that we get that nice bend. The foot doesn't look too different, but I'm going to move it a tiny bit to kind of relax it as he's walking. And now for the back leg, that back thigh actually looks like it's still in pretty good shape. This calf needs to rotate. And I want to follow that same angle. Obviously, I don't want to ever bend my leg. Well, with a skeleton, maybe I do. But for most things, you want to keep them somewhat natural. A tiny little bend at the knee is helpful. My foot doesn't have this two-part, but if you were to create your own character, that would be a great idea to have that. I'm going to... Actually, I think what I'll do before I move the foot is I'm going to move my hips up so that I can clearly make contact with the ground. So I am going to tip this a little bit differently, a little bit more upward. And I'm going to move those hips again just a tiny bit down. Now remember, I can't exactly line up my hips in terms of height with this character because my skeleton is taller, but that's okay. Actually, it's not that he's taller. He's got longer legs proportionally. Okay, so now I've got my second position. And so to repeat this, I would go to the third frame and repeat this again. Unlock my template drawing. This is that all-important crossover position. Again, I'm aligning the hips. Lock that background. The reason I lock that background is it doesn't want to sit still when you start moving the thighs. Select all. Make a keyframe. Etc., etc. So I'm going to pause now, and then when I come back, I will have done my full cycle, which is going to take 8 frames, 4 for the front leg, 4 for the back leg. The 8th one is going to be a duplicate of the first one. So in all, I have 7 positions. And once I have that done, I'll come back and show you the next steps. So now I've got my completed walk cycle, and yes, he is walking very slow, but as I mentioned earlier, I'll be able to speed him up pretty darn easily. So I think I'll go ahead and show you how to do that right now. And then I wanted to point out a technique that a lot of people use on their walk cycle, but I've tried it on this guy and I didn't like the look of it. So let's do one thing at a time. Let me stop this. And what I want to do to shorten the time as well as to add the easy ease on is to grab all of my keyframes. And to do that, I've got the rotation open on all. I know that I need to do the rotation on the skull and also the position because I have some keyframes on position. And I know that I also have the position on my hips. So I'm going to hold down the shift key and hit P on that as well. I also want to reveal all my shy layers, which happen to be locked, so that wouldn't work terribly well. I'm going to select them all, and I'm going to hit the R to reveal the rotation keyframes. And lastly, I can go ahead and hide that template. Okay, so I'm ready to select all of my keyframes. And you can do that by pulling a rectangle, but I tend to be somewhat clumsy, especially when they go the full length. So an option would be to click on the characteristic, the transform, such as position and rotation. So I'm going to try and do this quickly. Click on each of these, rotation, 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 slide downward, rotation. And you can see as I'm selecting them, they're turning yellow. Rotation. Holding down the shift key, make sure you're holding down the shift key to do this. I think I'm almost there, yes. Rotation, rotation, rotation. So I should see that all of my keyframes are yellow now. And to shorten the time frame so he can speed up a little bit, I'm just going to hold down the Option key on the Mac, hold down the Alt key on the PC, and just drag it much closer. So I'm going to bring it to under 2 seconds here. And let's take a look. It should speed him up considerably. There he goes, bopping along. And he stops because I've got one set of legs, one walk cycle. And now we're going to go to the next part, which is to have it so that it will loop for the duration of this composition. And to do that, we're going to use something called expressions. But before I do that, I wanted to show you something that might make your walk cycle look good. I didn't, as I said, like it on mine. I can more easily grab everything now that the whole timeline isn't involved. I'm going to just use the other technique, which is to pull a rectangle. So much easier. And to put on an easy ease, all I need to do is right-click and go to Keyframe Assistant. And then you can see the easy ease. It's also got an F9. So I'm going to go ahead and do the F9. On a laptop, don't forget to hold down that FN key. And keeping those selected. Actually, that's not going to look so great. So I will play it now with the easy ease. And I think you'll agree in my case that it looks strange with the easy ease in it. But a lot of people like what that will do to your walk cycle. I don't particularly like it. So I'm going to undo and get back to my regular easing. By the way, if you have an easy ease and you want to get rid of it, let me go ahead and put this back on, and you don't like it, what you can do is go back in, and I'm right-clicking, go instead to keyframe interpolation, and where it says Bezier, just change it back to linear, and that will return your keyframe to a normal keyframe. So the next step will be, again, to add the expression so that this will loop for the remainder of the composition. Unfortunately, I can't select all and do this, but this is how it works. I'm going to Alt-click or Option-click on the stopwatch. Be careful when you do this. You do not want to just click on the stopwatch because remember, that will remove all your keyframes. Not something you want to have happen after you've done all this work. And what that's going to give me is an expression. Now, there's a default expression here, and I could either type an expression here, or I can use this little arrow. So actually, in this case, I'm going to do a little bit of each. I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to go under Property, and I'm going to choose Loop Out. And this is more than what I need. All I actually need is the loop out and the cycle. So we're using a little bit of the automated, and I'm editing this. We only have to do this one time. I'm going to copy it now, and I'm going to Alt-click on each stopwatch and paste it. So what does this do? Well, I've got the skull. Let me get one leg completed, which is the right, upper, lower, and hand. Let me click on each of these and paste. So it's Option click, Command V, Option click, Command V, and Option click, Command V. So now you can see I've got the loop out on the arm. So if I play this now where everything isn't looped out, it's going to play the first walk cycle and then it's going to just move the arm. So there it is, first cycle, and now that one arm, oh, and the head, are going to keep going. Woohoo! So I'm going to pause for a moment and I'm going to go ahead and do all of my loop outs, and then you'll see the full walk cycle. So here it is now with the skeleton continuously looping for 8 seconds. If I need this to be longer, I can certainly make it longer. And now that I've got this in a composition, the last thing I'm going to want to do is to bring it into another composition and have him either walk across the screen or walk in place so that he appears to be moving through an environment. I'll be right back. So I've gone ahead and built a landscape for my skeleton to walk through using straight parallax. It doesn't include a camera, it's just flat two-dimensional layers moving at different paces. You can see I've got some trees in the very foreground and then a middle ground with some fog and some more trees. Further back, the pine trees, a little cemetery, some hills, and at the very back I've got the moon rising on a blue background. So that's the environment that I want to put my skeleton in. So I've positioned him at the very beginning on the right-hand side, and then further along the timeline I've positioned him so that he's actually leaving the stage. Now when I say him, I'm referring to the composition that has the marching in place skeleton, and by having the composition change position from right to left, it gives the appearance of him walking. So here's a quick preview. We're not hearing it right now, but I've added a couple of owl sounds. They are barred owls, Ohio barred owls, to give it just a nice autumnal feeling. So I'm going to render that out, and that's how we'll close our movie. Mm-mm.